It's time now for Media Watch, and Emma James is with us in the studio. Good to see you, Emma.
Hi there.
You've been looking at the latest story of a heroic migrant here in France. We were, of course, talking about Mamoudou Gassama just a week ago, weren't we, after he rescued that child off a balcony. This migrant, though, has been getting some very different treatment from the French government.
Yes, absolutely. If the case of Mamoudou Gassama laid bare hypocrisy when it comes to attitudes to migrants, well, it's laid even barer still by this particular story, because Aymen Latrous is the latest man to be outed as a lifesaver. But apparently that's not enough to keep him in the country. He's 25 years old. He's Tunisian. He came to France in 2013. Back in 2015, he saved the life of two children by rushing into a thick, black, smoke-filled, well-ablaze apartment in order to rescue two kids who were inside. Now, he had two friends with him. He's the one on the right-hand side of the photograph that you were just looking at. He actually fled the scene afterwards because he was fearing arrest and perhaps being...
Sure, because he didn't have papers.
Exactly. The mother then made an appeal for information because she wanted to thank him and his friends, and so he was then given a medal by the mayor of Foss in the Val d'Oise, which is just north of the Paris Charles de Gaulle airport. But now he has been told to leave. In 2018, 3 years after this happened, he's been told he has to leave, even though the mayor of Foss has actually given his backing, saying he should be given citizenship, be allowed to stay. He studied computer science, he wants to work in France, he wants to build a life here. Lots of people reacting to this one, and it is getting more and more attention. He obviously contacted the papers in the wake of Mamoudou Gassama's case to try to see if the same thing could be done for him. And he is getting some celebrity backing, including this TV presenter, who quotes the article saying, without a camera, his brave act didn't have the impact of Mamoudou Gassama's. This person pointing out that he should be made a fireman too, because, of course, that is what the future holds for Mamoudou Gassama. And she points out that if Mamoudou's act hadn't been caught on film, then maybe he would have suffered the same fate here in France too. Roger Carucci, who is a Republican senator and former minister, is actually calling on Emmanuel Macron to make the same gesture that he did to Mamoudou Gassama. A lot of people accused Macron of really seizing the political opportunity.
It was good PR, wasn't it?
It was very good PR, and a lot of people feeling that it's going to be an empty gesture if he doesn't actually extend the same courtesy to this gentleman too. Now, with media attention growing, his case is now being reviewed. So it's hoped that if he can prove what he did, then he will be allowed to stay.
OK, we'll have to... keep a close eye on that one to see what happens. We're going to talk about something else now. It is 29 years today, unbelievable, since the crackdown on pro-democracy protesters in Tiananmen Square in China. And there is a lot of pressure, mostly from the United States, in fact, on the government to reveal what happened.
Yes, and we still don't even know how many people were killed in that event, which started on this day, June the 4th, 1989. Now, what a lot of people are marking this occasion with today is the hashtag TankMan2018. Now, this person is using that iconic image, probably one of the best known photographs or images of the 20th century, a lone man in front of a row of tanks, just holding two shopping bags. Now, interestingly, there is a Chinese dissident artist, not Ai Weiwei, but Bajiao Cao, I hope I've pronounced that correctly.
Sounded good to me.
it probably wasn't. But he's actually calling on people to actually stage reenactments, to really flood social media with these images.
Because in China, you can't even search for Tiananmen Square online, can you? It is completely blacked out on
absolutely,
all internet.
Absolutely. Sources. The censorship is still alive and well in China. Now, 2 years ago, I should point out that Bajiao Cao actually lives in Adelaide, so he is able to do things like this. Two years ago, he did this as a kind of a living art piece, if you like. He stood in the centre of Adelaide city centre holding those two shopping bags, and that is all about paying tribute to the man whose identity we still don't know. We've had a few names suggested, but nobody knows for certain who that man was. All we know is that he was exceptionally brave. Now, people around the world are following suit. This is somebody here in Paris who has chosen to take up the challenge. This is a woman in Canada in front of a statue, the goddess of democracy, see, which was it's a replica of what was actually in Tiananmen Square. It was destroyed during those protests. And this gentleman as well, posting his images from Washington. Now, he was actually a Chinese activist who was a student leader during those protests. And he's currently in Washington, and he's taken all his photographs with shopping bags. Now, you may notice that those shopping bags have some images on them. They're taken from the artist's website, because he's urging people, urging people to download these images to really hammer home the messages about censorship and China.
Because Peppa Pig was banned, wasn't she?
Peppa Pig was banned. It was deemed to be a negative influence. Winnie the Pooh is also banned because people keep likening him to the president, Xi Jinping, which he's not happy about. There is a little bit of a likeness there. And on the right-hand side, I love this, Rice Bunny. When you say it in Mandarin, it sounds like me too. So that is how feminists have been getting around censorship, because they can't use the hashtag Me Too because it will be blocked. So they're using Rice Bunny instead. So it's a way of reinforcing the ability to give some images. I think my favourite image of the day, though, shows that the generations to come will always remember Tank Man. This was taken in Sydney. And look, she's got a little Winnie the Pooh at her feet there.
And a very nice reindeer jumper as well, as we said. All right, finally, tennis fans are pretty disappointed today because Serena Williams has had to pull out because of injury.
Yes, absolutely.
Real shocker.
If you were looking at social media this morning, lots of people couldn't understand why so many media outlets were really playing up the rivalry, saying this is going to be a huge showdown between these two great rivals. Serena Williams has beaten Maria Sharapova 19 times to 2. It's really not that great a rivalry. And this person pouring scorn on the idea that Serena Williams would be troubled by meeting Maria Sharapova. Live footage of Serena Williams training, and she is, in fact, curled up in bed. When it was announced that she was pulling out because of injury, well, somebody tweeted this image of SpongeBob SquarePants, heaving a sigh of relief, saying that that is Maria Sharapova in the locker room, having heard that she doesn't have to face Serena. But one thing there's a big fuss about online is an interview that was done by Inside Tennis with Serena Williams, probably the best female tennis player we have ever seen, maybe we'll ever see.
She's won it so many times, hasn't she?
And people are outraged because Bill Simons chose to ask her if she was intimidated by Sharapova's supermodel good looks back in 2004.
Well, she doesn't look too shabby herself, Serena Williams, does she? I mean, come
on. Exactly. And people saying this is racist and it's sexist and it really shouldn't happen.
People love a cat fight, don't they? All right, Emma, thank you very much indeed. Emma James there.